King Suddhodana's death. King Suddhodana was a powerful and wealthy king who ruled over the Shakya kingdom, a region located in the foothills of the Himalayas in present-day Nepal. He was married to Queen Maya, who was known for her beauty and grace. One day, Queen Maya became pregnant, and it was prophesied that she would give birth to a child who would either become a great king or a great spiritual leader. When the time came for the child to be born, Queen Maya traveled to her hometown of Devadaha to give birth. However, on the way, she stopped at the Lumbini Grove to rest under a sal tree. While she was there, she went into labor, and a son was born. The child was named Siddhartha, which means one who has achieved his goal. King Suddhodana was overjoyed at the birth of his son and spared no expense in celebrating the occasion. He ordered his servants to distribute gifts and food to the people of the kingdom, and he himself gave alms to the poor and needy. He also summoned the best astrologers and scholars to examine the child's horoscope and predict his future. The astrologers predicted that Siddhartha would become a great spiritual leader and would renounce the world to seek enlightenment. This worried Suddhodana, who had hoped that his son would follow in his footsteps and become a great king. To ensure that Siddhartha received the best education possible, Suddhodana hired the best teachers and scholars to instruct him in various arts and sciences. As Siddhartha grew up, he showed great promise and intelligence. He was trained in archery, horseback riding, and sword fighting, and he became skilled in various arts and sciences. However, he was troubled by the suffering he saw around him and became determined to find a way to alleviate it. When Siddhartha was 29 years old, he left the palace and embarked on a spiritual journey, seeking enlightenment. He wandered the countryside, seeking teachings from various spiritual masters and practicing meditation and asceticism. After several years, he realized that asceticism was not the path to enlightenment and began practicing the middle way, a path of moderation and balance. Eventually, Siddhartha achieved enlightenment and became known as the Buddha, the Enlightened One. He traveled the countryside, giving teachings on the nature of suffering and the path to liberation. He gained many followers and became a respected spiritual leader. Meanwhile, Suddhodana grew older and weaker. He realized that his son had found a greater purpose in life and began to regret his earlier attempts to keep Siddhartha at home. He longed to see his son one last time and make amends for any mistakes he had made. When the Buddha heard that his father was gravely ill, he traveled to the kingdom of Kapilavastu to see him. Suddhodana was overjoyed to see his son again and they embraced warmly. However, Suddhodana was still clinging to his old beliefs and asked the Buddha to perform some miracles to prove his spiritual power. The Buddha gently refused, explaining that miracles were not the way to attain enlightenment. Instead, he spoke to his father about the Four Noble Truths and the Eightfold Path, the core teachings of Buddhism. Suddhodana listened carefully and was deeply moved by his son's wisdom and compassion. After their conversation, Suddhodana passed away peacefully, surrounded by his family and loved ones. The Buddha stayed with his father's body for several days, performing last rites and giving teachings on impermanence and the nature of suffering. The death of Suddhodana marked the end of an era and the passing of a great king, but it also marked the beginning of a new era of spiritual growth and enlightenment in the Shakya kingdom. The Buddha continued to teach and spread his message of compassion and wisdom throughout the region, gaining more and more followers. Siddhartha's own son, Rahula, became one of his most devoted disciples, and many members of the Shakya royal family also embraced his teachings. The Buddha continued to travel and teach for several more decades, inspiring countless people to follow the path to enlightenment. Today, the legacy of King Suddhodana and his son, the Buddha, lives on in the hearts and minds of millions of people around the world. The story of their lives teaches us the importance of compassion, wisdom, and selflessness, and inspires us to strive for greater understanding and enlightenment.